Hi boys and girls.
Hi boys and girls.
It is yet another lovely Sunday and it's good to be here with you. Auntie Anne, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And how are you?
I'm okay, thank you.
Wonderful.
I hope your weeks went well. Mm-hmm. We're slowly approaching the end of the terms and you might be excited that you might be going on holiday soon. But today we're going to continue with our lessons, and today Auntie Anne has a special lesson planned out for us. Mm-hmm. But before we look into the lesson, I will pray for us. Shall we pray?
Jesus loves me. I love Jesus.
Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day that you've given to us and for the gift of life. Thank you for bringing us in such a manner to listen to your word. We ask that you might go before us and give us understanding. Help us apply to our hearts that which we will hear and indeed be able to practice when we go out and tell of your good news. Help us to not be like the Pharisees, but to place our trust in you and to be able to tell others of your love. We bring these things before you, asking that you might be with us as we teach as well and go before us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
So, we're going to sing a hymn today because mm-hmm. it is necessary and in line with our lesson for today. So don't worry, the words are going to be shown on the screen and it's "Give me a sight, O Savior." So please just look at the words on the screen and follow through with us as we sing. I think we can just go through it to teach you and then we will sing it properly together. Give me a sight, O Savior, of thy wondrous love to me, of the love that brought thee down to earth to die on Calvary. Oh, make me understand it, help me to take it in. What it meant to thee, the Holy One, to bear away my sin. Okay, so I hope you were able to get it. And now we're going to sing through it again a little bit faster. But I hope you were able to hear the tune. It is a familiar hymn, or we may have not sung it in a while. Give me a sight, O Savior, of thy wondrous love to me, of the love that brought thee down to earth to die on Calvary. Oh, make me understand it, help me to take it in. What it meant to thee, the Holy One, to bear away my sin. Oh, make me understand it, help me to take it in. What it meant to thee, the Holy One, to bear away my sin.
Well, boys and girls, we pick up our story in the book of Mark, now in chapter 3. Having looked at the first story on prejudice, how people were opposed to Jesus and made judgment against him, and also how there was so much pride and
prejudice,
yes. And the second lesson
was superiority and pride,
yes, looking at how it's like, I'm better than this person. That's having a superiority complex, where you think that you are better than others. Just like the Pharisees thought they were better, they were superior, they were above, okay, the other people and the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Well, boys and girls, today we're looking at hardness and hate, okay? Hardness and hate. Boys and girls, have you ever tried to squeeze a stone? I want you to try this. Get a stone and put it in water. And then get one of those sponges, the ones we use for washing the dishes, boys and girls. Also put it in water. And then get them out. Try to squeeze water out of the stone. And then try to squeeze water out of the sponge. Which one do you think would give us more water when you squeeze it?
The sponge.
The sponge. Boys and girls, some of us are like sponges. We drink in God's word. We believe the word of God, and it just fills us and soaks us. And when we're squeezed, we're so soft. The word of God comes out and blesses other people. But some are as hard as that stone. The word comes to them, and yet they cannot or will not obey God's word. Well, boys and girls, this is what we have for today's story. Mark chapter 3, and we're going to read from verses 1 to verse 9, or verse 6, somewhere there, verse 6. And as he entered the synagogue again, and a man was there who had a withered hand. Now, a withered hand, boys and girls, is shriveled. You know, it cannot stretch, so it's all bent up. And it cannot go forward. It cannot do anything. It's permanently that way. And so there was a man with a withered hand. So they, meaning the Pharisees and the scribes, the teachers of the law, watched him, meaning Jesus. They watched Jesus closely, whether he would heal him on the Sabbath. Now, the Sabbath was a holy day, boys and girls. It was a day when they went to church, so to say. They went to the synagogue, okay? And they were not to do anything except worship God. And the Pharisees and the scribes and the teachers of the law had put so many rules. Boys and girls, do you know rules? Rules are meant to help us to keep order and to help us be good people. And so rules are good. But now the Pharisees had added to God's rules so many burdensome things. And so they determined how they were going to dress. The Pharisees didn't want to dress like other people. They wanted to dress in their long robes so that they could be seen and given respect by what they wore. They wanted the front seats in the temple, in the synagogues where the teaching was taking place. They also told people not to cook, not to wash their dishes, not to carry certain weights. They had to wash their hands before eating in a certain way. Not just the hands. They would wash the whole arms, because then, you know, that was like they're washing in a ceremonial way. They had so many rules, boys and girls. These rules were not a joy to follow anymore. And one of the rules they had was that they were meant to gather at God's house. And those who had illnesses and or sicknesses and diseases should not be healed on the Sabbath. Let them be healed on other days. And so this particular Sabbath day, Jesus was teaching, and they deliberately put this man, they knew he had a shriveled hand, And he was right in front of the congregation, right where Jesus could see him. And you know, they were watching closely to see if Jesus would heal that man, because they knew that Jesus was merciful and compassionate and loving. And he would definitely not want to see someone suffering. That man could not use his hand. It was shriveled. It was withered. And he couldn't do anything with it. And so, boys and girls, what happens? Let's read from God's word. It says, so they watched him closely, whether he would heal him on the Sabbath, so that they might accuse him. Boys and girls, how horrible to want to accuse the Lord Jesus Christ for a good deed that he was going to do and setting him up. Are there people who set you up for things sometimes? Or are you in the habit of setting others up? And so you put your chocolate deliberately on the table to see if your brother or sister would take it and that you would accuse them of stealing. You break something and piece it together so that when the next person just touches it, it falls apart and you say, I'll tell for you, you broke mommy's plate or you broke daddy's cup. Is that what you do? You set people up. These Pharisees set up the Lord Jesus Christ, knowing that the man with the shriveled hand would be for him a temptation, so to say, to heal him. But of course, Jesus is compassionate and loving, and he knew what was in their hearts because he is God. He said to the man who had a withered hand, step forward. And so the man stepped forward, boys and girls. He didn't know what was going to happen. Remember, this man didn't ask for healing. It was the Sabbath. There are many rules about what you should do and what you should not do on the Sabbath. So he didn't ask Jesus to heal him. He came to listen to God's word, and he was seated there with his shriveled hand. And Jesus told him to step forward. And so he steps forward, and then Jesus asks and says, is it lawful, okay, by law? Remember, there are many rules the Pharisees have given. Is it lawful on the Sabbath to do good or to do evil, to save life or to kill? Now, that was not a tricky question, boys and girls. It was a truthful question the Lord Jesus was asking, knowing what was in the hearts of these Pharisees and teachers of the law and scribes. They wanted to accuse him. And so he asks them a question. He brings this man forward because their aim and objective was to make Jesus do something unlawful on the Sabbath. And so Jesus asked them, is it a good thing to do good on the Sabbath or to do evil? To save life or to kill? Can you imagine if on a Sunday morning you fall ill, seriously ill, you are vomiting, you are in pain, you are getting dehydrated. Water, you need the doctor. And then you go to the hospital and the doctor says, hello, today is Sunday, can you come back tomorrow? What would you think of that doctor? Today is Sunday, I don't attend to patients. I'm here, yes, but I don't attend to patients on Sunday. Huh. Or your parents say, well, Johnny, you're not feeling well and you're very sick. We're going to church. We're going to the house of the Lord. We can't attend to you. We need to go about the business of the Lord. And they leave you to die. Is that right, boys and girls? No. So this man was brought forward. And the Lord asked the question, is it right to do what is good or what is evil on the Sabbath? And the Pharisees, the scribes, and the teachers of the law who were looking to oppose Jesus, who were looking to accuse Jesus, were silent. They were quiet. They didn't say a word. And this made Jesus really angry and grieved. See, boys and girls, these people hated those who were suffering and in need of a savior. They hated the people they claimed to share God's word with. And so Jesus said to him, stretch out your hand. And he stretched forth his hand, and he was healed instantly. Boys and girls, Jesus has compassion. But there are those in church who come to churches who do not know anything about the mercy of God or the grace of God, and they don't want to share these with others. And sometimes we look and say, I don't like going to church because people pretend. Well, boys and girls, it's not up to you. You don't make judgment and don't behave in a way because others are behaving wrongly. These people were hardened in their hearts and they had proper hatred. They didn't want Jesus, they didn't love Jesus, and they didn't want to do anything, okay, that honored God. They were about themselves, their rules, and all that. Do you come to church, boys and girls, and you see those orphaned children, the poor among you, and you feel, I don't want to associate, I don't want to sit with this one. Oh, they smell. Oh, they're not dressed nicely. They can't be my friends. Is that the attitude you have? If you come to church like that, boys and girls, you have hatred for those who genuinely want to hear God's word and love him, and you are not sharing God's good news to the needy or to the poor or those in your midst. Boys and girls, what is your attitude? How do you behave towards those who are less fortunate than yourselves, towards those who perhaps are different from you? They may have a disability. Perhaps they don't talk. Perhaps they're blind. Perhaps they're lame. What is your attitude towards those people? Do you love them with the love of God? Or do you hate them like the Pharisees and are waiting to see, let's see if they'll be helped. Let's see what is going to happen to them. Boys and girls, let's say our memory verse and let us remember that we too can be like these people who opposed Jesus by the things we do today. All right, so let us memorize Mark chapter 3, verse 1. Okay?
Mark chapter 3, verse 1.
Again.
Mark chapter 3, verse 1. And Jesus entered into the synagogue.
Again.
And Jesus entered into the synagogue.
And what did he do?
And healed the man with a withered hand.
And what did he do?
And healed a man with a withered hand.
One more time.
And healed a man with a withered hand.
So let's say the whole verse, chapter, verse, and let's say it. So,
Mark chapter 3, verse 1. And Jesus entered into the synagogue and healed a man with a withered hand.
Oh, boys and girls, what is your attitude going to be this Sunday when you enter into the house of the Lord? Is it with a hardness of heart, not willing to accept God's word and what he's doing for other people and a hatred? Or are you going to come as soft as that sponge, that you soak in God's word and that you will spread it out to others? May God bless you and help you as you listen to God's word this morning. For now, we'll say
bye.